Have you lived here your whole life?
No, I moved here from Korea when I was 7. My dad got transferred in his job. I've been going around different states. I was in Texas for a little bit, Houston. Most of the time I lived in Torrance.
Now, how did you discover poker? You've been playing for a long time.
I was always into playing cards and gambling. I felt like I was like destined to play poker. Everything just happened, unfolded the way it did, and how moneymaker thing became real popular in 2003, and just everything just lined up perfectly for me to play poker.
How did you learn to play? How did you discover the game?
I mean, just like a lot of people, I start off by watching rounders, right? That got me really into no limit hold'em.
And how old were you back then?
I was 17, okay. 16, yeah. From that point on, you know, poker got popular and we all drifted into poker. And I was waiting for that. I was waiting to turn 18 so I could play in the casino.
Do you remember your first World Poker Tour event?
Yes, the very first one after I turned 21 was the 25K WPT Championships. And I was second in chips after day one and I busted day two. And that was in 2006.
That was your first World Poker Tour event. It was a $25,000 buy-in.
That was like 3 days after I turned 21. So that was my first event.
Wow, you didn't muck around.
I mean, I pretty much put up my whole bankroll to play that tournament. So I was all in.
Okay, so then there was a bit of recovery afterwards, but you did it. You went for the dream.
I did.
Felt good.
Yeah, and I just kept going for it.
So you do have a couple months to prepare.
Yeah.
As a poker player, you're going to work on yourself, obviously, but then, you know, when it comes to like strategy, studying your opponents, are you doing any of that?
I feel like I don't need to do all that because I just want to be in the moment. When I'm in the moment, I will get the reads that I need and I'll get the help from the universe that I need.
So when you play poker in more of a spiritual way, what does it mean?
I was able to look at poker in a different way that I'm sure most people don't see it this way. And I play more of a spiritual way. I want to, you know, eventually introduce to the world.
I love the sound of it. You've been doing a lot of work, huh?
I've been doing a ton of work and most of the credit goes to my coach, my spiritual healer, Ray Johnston in Hawaii, in Honolulu. It was a blessing that he came into my life at the time he did and in the way he did.
I saw you had a nice big win in Vegas and you posted on your Instagram your winning photo with your opponent from this final table, Frank. You know, I love that. You guys are friends. You bonded clearly while playing this game. And he's quite a character.
He's an amazing character and he's an amazing person too. I definitely see him as my biggest challenge. He knows what he's doing. And I mean, I was grateful that he actually sweated me through the whole final table when I won the win. And yeah, he's a good friend of mine. So back when I was doing community service over here, This area was where I was assigned to sweep each freaking particle as much as I could all the way up. And I would enjoy it because it allowed me to be away from the supervisors and I could get on my phone kind of, you know. As long as they're not watching. You know.
Still going against the rules.
Still going against the rules. Yeah.
But here we are now on this same ramp and we're talking about you possibly winning a WPT title, something you have been trying to do for over a decade and it is so close. Well, let's see if Steve Soong gets his name etched onto the WPT Champions Cup. He'll be taking his seat at the HyperX Esports Arena in Las Vegas on March 12th at 4 p.m. Good luck.